the one that I'm just talking with Venerable Chandra, that we're not going to do a guided meditation on the following days, in this time of the afternoon. I looked at the schedule and it's a bit much, but it is also the fact that guided meditations are excellent when we start meditating. They get us pointed in the correct direction. A guided meditation is like a driving instructor sitting next to you in the car when you haven't got your license yet, who tells you, put the brake on now, stop. It's someone who gives guidance at the very beginning, just so you can get started and get some confidence in the way you're meditating. However, that for many people, that it's a bit of a unnecessary intrusion. That you're meditating, you're going the right direction, you know what to do, and have somebody come and tell you to do what you're already doing. Sometimes it's an intrusion, a distraction. That you want to go inside at the same time, you're trying out of respect to listen to sound coming from outside of you. So just do the guided meditation now. Sometimes during the morning talks, I'll do a little bit of guided meditation when it's appropriate. So this means the afternoons will be free for you from all afternoon until 4 p.m. is the word of the Buddha class. So anyway, this is a guided meditation for today. So you close your eyes, that's the first bit of guidance. The reason why we close our eyes is because that's one sense which we don't need to concern ourselves about. Human beings are very visual. We recognize one another by how we look. When we close those eyelids, after a short while, the sense of seeing vanishes and disappears. It turns off. Which means that our brain has more capacity to be able to feel the body, listen to the sounds, especially those two senses. Smell and taste is not very much of an impingement. So in particular, as I mentioned on the first guided meditation last night, we want to find about our body. In the Buddha's teachings on meditation, we'd always start with kaya sati, which is mindfulness of your body. We feel our body. We get to know our body. And when we get to know our body, we can actually learn from our body. So first of all, there's a general awareness of how you are sitting. There is nothing magical about sitting in full lotus. We find a position which is best for us. So become aware of your legs first of all. And move them if you need to. How are your feet? How the calves go If you ask the question and you do this regularly, you can actually feel sensations in your calves, even in the bones and the skin. We're making a neural connection to that part of the body. And once we are looking there, we can actually make that part of the body more comfortable. Learn from your lower legs. And then to your knees. Many people do have problems with their knees. I'm 67 now, but my knees are great. I can sit down, cross them, not give me any trouble. Because I've been aware of them for such a long time. And if there is any tightness or tension somewhere, I can learn by being aware, mindful of that part of the body, just the knees, zooming in, just like you zoom in on Google Earth, zoom in on that part of the body. And find out how to ease the tightness. To relax the tension. Sometimes even just visualizing the tightness being like either something being stretched, like a string being stretched on both ends, and letting go of both ends. Or like a sponge which is squashed and pressed. And then taking off the compression, the force, and just letting that part of your body just expand. The visualizations, as I am being aware of that part of the body. I can feel that part of the body release its tightness, its tensions, its inflammation. At first I only notice a little bit of improvement, but it's going in the right direction. I continue to let go, expand, allow things to be, to take their natural shape. And then it feels at ease. And I go up to my thighs. Feel a tingling sensation. That's for me anyway. Everything there is, I just don't just take it for granted. Making sure all that part of the body is comfortable. And then I go to my buttocks. Feel the pressure sitting on that cushion. Sometimes if you don't sit in a good posture, sometimes you get what we call pins and needles in your legs, or like the leg goes asleep. Just means you have a numbness there, which is not a problem, but it can be irritating. So if you can adjust your bottom on the chair or on the cushion, then you find that doesn't happen. So I'm aware of those muscles, making sure the cushion is in exactly the right place. I know that I can't get any more comfortable than this, as far as that part of my body is concerned. And I move up to my waist. I don't take any of these parts of my body for granted. I don't just sweep up and that's okay. Preparation is crucial for any endeavor. Go to my waist, just feel it, check it out. As if you have a child and you are settling them into bed at night. You tuck them in, make them feel safe, secure. See if there's anything they need. And then they will fall asleep. My waist, make sure everything there is fine. And just caring for it, giving it attention, is sometimes all that a child needs. It's all that the waist needs to relax and be comfortable. And then I move up, out my chest. And personally I can feel a bit of tightness in my chest. Because I ate too much of lunch. Very delicious food. I feel that. I relax it. Give me a kindness. Whenever you do that, the body becomes more at ease. Done a lot of work on indigestions, even food poisoning, irritable bowel syndrome. Feel it, get to know it, relax it. Only a tiny bit. Those many tiny bits of relaxation in these, they build and build and build until the problem goes. Moving up, up to my shoulders. You can pause anywhere as you sweep up your body. If you feel there's something not quite right, linger there. I've taught this with great effect to people in cancer groups. Feel when there's something not quite right. You can't even put a name on it. Feel it. And learn how to ease it. How to heal it. How to bring beautiful energy there. So the tumors never form. Really aware of sweep up my body, checking if anything which is out of the ordinary, linger, zoom in, and imagine things expanding, easing. So what I first thought was tightness and tension, it just fades away. With mindfulness, it does give you the opportunity for feedback. You can see how things change. And your wisdom understands what has changed for the better and changed for the worse. You learn the causes that things change for the better. Or what makes them worse. shoulders to the same. I learn how to relax, loosen tension, untighten knots, expand rather than contract. Allow the subject to take its natural shape instead of forcing it into a box. At the same time, I'm mindful, aware, kind, letting things be. Letting things be is not an act of irresponsibility. I can feel letting be heals and relaxes. Letting be is a very positive activity. I must lift down my arms. Pretty okay. My elbows. Don't usually have any problems. My elbows, but I check just in case. Go up my arms, my upper arms. My left arm, I can feel the tension holding the microphone. It's not a problem. It's very much like the tension in my buttocks. Even though I'm not going to move, let me just relax. And feel that tension become comfortable without even moving anything. And feel my hands, exclusively aware of my hands. It's almost a miracle. Just being awake, aware, feeling sensations. One which is grasping the metal, which is now warm, of the microphone. The other one just resting on my robe. Totally different tactile sensations. Both very comfortable and interesting. I go back out to my shoulders, just relaxing. Go up to my neck, still an irritation from some sort of allergies. The irritation is so light, it's like a feather in my throat. And the feather doesn't move. Stop tickling. I let the almost a bit of heaviness, tightness in the muscles inside my throat. I don't try and relieve them. I let them be. Just being here. Not trying to get rid of those feelings, but embracing them, welcoming them. You too could be inside my body, irritation. Everything gets calm, soft. I go up further. My head. Especially to the front of my face. People do have tightness around eyes, forehead, mouth. Which, as I said, why you can read their emotions. can see the well-being. I learn how to relax those muscles. Trial and error over the years. Just need to look at any tightness around your eyes. And feel the tightness around the mouth. Feel the heaviness of those muscles. You let them be. They relax, loosen. Just like sometimes imagine these muscles lying on the softest of cotton cushions. No pressure on them. No tension. No strain. And last of all, actually not last of all, I go to 2 inches behind my eyes, where I imagine the center of my brain is. Each one of us in our life have had to face so many problems and find solutions. The zombies are still ongoing. But we have forced our brain, sometimes abused it with too much thought and worry. Imagine my mindfulness in the center of the brain. Giving waves of kindness from the center, spreading to every square millimeter, every neuron in my brain, relaxing it, easing it. I used to walk too much and my feet were tired. I used to soak them in warm water. And I imagine my brain soaking in warm water. Just my image of relaxing, easing. Instead of in parts, all together as one whole. The whole thing feels good, at ease, relaxed, at peace. And I look for and notice the delight of a relaxed body. Beautiful, tingling, comfort. And when people go on holiday overseas, you see them sitting in recliners under the sun or under the shade of a tree. Nothing to do, nowhere to go. Content, at peace. People pay a lot of money for that, the delight of relaxation. I feel that in my body now. No tightness, no tension anywhere. I open, free, without tension. Moment without stress is healthy, enjoyable, and highly beneficial in all ways. As we learn the lost art of knowing how to relax, I indulge in that feeling of relaxation. I'm not afraid to linger there, because I know its benefits. And then I go on to my mind. As I relax my body, so I'm going to relax the mind, using mindfulness and letting things be. Letting things be is another word for kindness. Opening the door of my heart to the content of this moment. So I look at my mind. It's a bit tired. Still some jet lag. Been working, and it's fun. It's not a problem. I feel my brain, my mind, how peaceful it is. Sometimes I imagine it like a lake. Sometimes it's so calm, like a grass surface on the body of water, not a ripple, but not a wave anywhere. Sometimes, when there's lots of things to do, it's like big waves on the surface of the lake, called the mind. I just let it be. My peaceometer. How peaceful am I? How agitated? Always recognize, if I just wander off into the future, if I just go bring things out from the past, that just creates waves, unnecessary agitations. I'm aware of this moment in my mind. It's all I have. When I pick up those suitcases or bags called past or future, they're really heavy. Put them down. My mind is like a feather. Floating on the breeze, weightless, not directed to go here or there, but free. That's how I imagine my mind. Free, just in this moment. With no reference points by which I can judge her. When there's a judgment, a measurement, there's always an improvement possible. When there's a location, another type of measurement, there's always somewhere else to go. All I have is here, now. I don't measure. There's no weight. somebody ever asked me, "Well, what are you aware of? Just this. Whatever's in front of your mind right now. And don't try to capture this moment with a name. Put it in a box. Carry it home with you to tell other people. But at times, you don't need to take notes to know. Just know. What's most important is to know the peace. In, not on, but in, inside of this. You don't move outwards to the next moment. You move in to this one. Once that direction has been set, going in. What's happening here? How does it feel? Those are my words, don't repeat them. Go in. And the deeper you go in, the more freedom, the greater the mindfulness, the greater the clarity. As you take away all of your concern and the resultant loss or leak of energy doing stuff, you stop. Stop here and go in. I'm now going to be quiet and see how far you go inside. this